So in this tutorial, I am going to show you that how you can use the power of Paint 3D and PowerPoint 2016 to create this stunning 3D DNA effect. First of all, I would like to tell you that if you have Windows 10, then you might have Paint 3D as well if you are using the latest version of Windows 10. As you can see that I have build 17134 and version is 1803. Even it is Paint 3D is also available in the earlier versions. And if you want to create custom 3D objects, then you need some applications where you can customize the object as you require. But if you are going to use the PowerPoint 3D models option, then you can easily insert the 3D models into PowerPoint, but you can't customize them. So the next thing is, if you don't have this 3D models option under the illustration section, that means you also need to check which version of PowerPoint 2016 is installed on your system. And for that, click on the File menu and then go to Accounts. And if you scroll down a bit, you can see that I have version 1805. And you can also notice that I have a subscription of Office 365. And I would like to thank Microsoft for giving me Office 365 subscription for 1 month absolutely free. And you can also click on Office Update and click on Update Now to see if that can install the latest update from Microsoft Server into your system. And then might you have get this 3D model options right here. So let's get started. Let me close this one. File, close. Now I am going to open a new file. Click on the file, then click new and then choose blank presentation. I no longer require this thumbnail view and I would like to change the layout to black. The first thing is to insert the custom 3D model that I have drawn using Paint 3D. And for that, I go to the Insert tab, click the 3D Models drop-down button and click From a File. If you just click on the 3D model on top, then it will bring the 3D library where you can get predefined 3D models just like this one, Anatomy. Under Anatomy, I can use the predefined DNA and click Insert. And here I have this one. Go to the Format. Go to the Align and Align Center, Align Middle, and I would like to rotate this just like that. And if I go to the animation and use the turntable animation on this one, then you can see that it is going to animate just the way I have created the DNA effect. But if you look carefully, then you can see that you can't customize anything here in this 3D model. That is why I have drawn that 3D shape in Paint 3D. Let me show you. Go to the Insert, click 3D Models, choose From a File and choose Single DNA String and choose Insert. And here I have this one. And you must also note one thing here, that in Paint 3D, after drawing your shape, go to the File menu and click Save As, and you must save your file as a 3D model. Just I have saved these two files in the GLB format, and when you will insert a 3D model using From a File option, then you can see that which file types PowerPoint 2016 support. So you must take care of these things, and that will be a transparent object. If you apply a form, if you apply a solid fill color in your slide, then you will notice that the object is separate from the background and it is not showing any white or any other colors along with the object. So now the next thing is, let me reduce the size. Now, do you want to apply the animation right now, or you want to copy the objects first and then apply the animation on all the objects? It totally depends on you that how you want to go. First of all, let me align the object into the center and the middle of the slide. And when you need to move the objects, if you hold down the Shift key, then it will move the object in a straight line. That makes it easier for you to align the objects in the same position. Now I want to duplicate this object several times here. And as I was telling you that, do you want to apply the animation first and then duplicate the objects, or you want to duplicate the objects first and then apply the animation? And that will create a little bit difference here, and I will show you that later on. So I am going to apply animation first and then I will duplicate the object. So after inserting the 3D model into your presentation, if you go to the animations tab, then you can see new animations here under the animation section. And if you click the add animation drop down button, then you will also see a 3D section here. And I am going to use turntable effect on this object. As I have clicked on turntable, and let me open the animation pane and click on play from to start the animation from the beginning. As you can see that the animation is playing with a 20 second duration, but you are not noticing anything here. Even though it is playing the animation, but you will not notice anything because it is moving on its anchor point, and the anchor point is right here. So that is why you are not noticing anything here. So what you can do, you can go to the effect option, and by default the spin rotation is set to right. The turntable rotation is set to right, and I want this rotation to be down. So that is what I wanted. And I would like to start this animation with previous with the duration of 2 seconds. Now open the effect option by double clicking on the effect. Go to the timing tab and set it to repeat until end of the slide. Okay. Now the second animation I am going to apply on this one is pulse. You can also use transparency if you like to, but I am going to use pulse effect with previous with the duration of 0.50 seconds and timing repeat until end of the slide. Okay, now I am going to duplicate this object, and for making several copies of this object, you can either use copy and paste command, but that way you have to arrange all the objects in the same line manually. And even if you use the Control D command to make a duplicate, which is an easier way of duplicating the object instead of copying and pasting, that way so you still have to move the objects manually to make them into the similar position. So here is another command that I would like to share with you, which will also save your time in future presentation, that is doing a smart cut and paste. And for that, move your mouse pointer near to the border of the selection, hold down the Control and Shift keys. Now you can see a plus sign with the mouse pointer, and if you now drag and drop this object, that not only will make a similar copy of the same object, but if you now press the F4 key, that will repeat your last command. And what that will do, that will place the object with the same distance and on the same position. And if I continue to press F4 key, then it will repeat the same command. You can also press Ctrl Y, or you can click on the redo button. That will also repeat the same command, Ctrl Y, if you press, as you can see that I am pressing Ctrl Y, but before that I had wrongly pressed Ctrl D key, which created a duplicate. If now I press Ctrl Y, then it will repeat the last command, which was Ctrl D. So if you have done some mistakes when using F4 key, then you have to repeat the command once, and then you can use the F4 key again. That much are enough here. And as I was telling you that why I have applied the animation first, that way when I was duplicating the object, that will also duplicate the animations. Let me show you another example here. Expand the thumbnail view and make a duplicate of your slide, and let me delete all these animations. Let me delete all these objects except one. And if now I duplicate the object first and then use F4 key to make several copies, and later if I apply the animation, let me delete all these animations. And later if I want to apply both of the animations that I had applied in the first slide, just like turntable with previous with the duration of 2 seconds, open the effect option by right clicking on the effects, go to the effect option, repeat until end of the slide, and again select all the objects, and this time apply the pulse effect with previous with the duration 0.50 seconds. Go to the effect option and repeat until end of the slide. So what is the difference between doing that? The difference is right here in the animation pan. As you can see that first you have all the turntable effects and then you have the pulse effect for each object. Whereas in the first slide, you have both the objects in a series. Like here you have both of the animations for the first string, then the next two animations for the second string. And if you select the second string, that will select both the animation right away. And here in the second slide, if I select the second string, then you can see that one animation is right here and one animation is on the top, which make it very difficult for you to select the animations when later you need to add delay timing between them. And what is that, I will show you right now. Now the only thing in this animation is to do is to add the delay timing. Let me adjust them right here. And for that, select the second string and then add a delay timing of 0.10 second and start adding a 0.10 second delay between all the objects, like 0.20 for the third one, 0.30 for the fourth one, 0.40 for the fifth one, and so on. And that is what all we need here. And let me show you the slideshow. And here you have the animation. So before I finish this tutorial, let me show you one more thing here. Make a duplicate of this slide. Select all the objects on your slide. Go to the format tab and make a group of all of them. Now again, go to the format tab. And this time you will see different options here in the format tab, because all these 3D objects now under a single group, so you will see different options. Now I am going to click on the rotate drop down button and want to rotate this object, rotate left 90 degree and later ungroup them. Now I am going to delete those objects which are outside the slide area. Now I am going to apply the same animation on this one, turntable for this one with previous with the duration of 2 seconds. Open the effect option, and if you want to remove the smoothness or add the smoothness, that totally depends on you. Go to the timing tab and repeat until end of the slide. And again, this time I am going to use down. The second animation is pulse with previous with the duration of 0.50 seconds. And a timing repeat until end of the slide. Now I want to animate all the objects as the top one with a delay timing of 0.10 second between each of them. So instead of applying the same animation again and again, what I can do, I can select the first one, click on the animation painter, and then click on the second one. That will only duplicate the animation on the first object to the second one. And you can repeat the same step, like selecting the second one, then clicking on the third one. But that will also take a lot of time. So instead of clicking again and again on Animation Painter, what you can do, you can double click on Animation Painter. And then you can start clicking on the rest of the objects. And that will start duplicating the animations on the following objects. And when you click on using the animation painter, then you can also notice that it is showing you the preview before stopping, and that is also going to waste a little bit time if you are not interested in seeing the preview. So what you can do, you can click on the next object and then again click. That will stop the preview, so you can quickly animate all the objects by duplicating the animation using the animation painter. And later you can add the delay timings. And later you can add the delay timing between the between each set of the animation. Let me show you that in my previous presentation. Just like that, I have added in this presentation a 0.10 second delay between each set of the animation. As you can see that. So I hope you will like this tutorial. Let me know by liking, sharing and commenting. And you can also subscribe to our channel and hit the bell icon. And you will get the future notifications whenever I will upload a new tutorial. Thanks for watching and have a great day.